join this special celebration of Christmas today. Children from our church school, our preschool, and our children choir ask a simple question. May I sing to you? You are all invited to join us in the journey through the Christmas story in song, poem, and scripture. As far as details go, all children, youth, and teens will remain in the sanctuary with us for worship today. The nursery is open if you have young children in need of care. We will produce a video of today's worship and make it available to all of you in the next few weeks so you can treasure and share this memory of Christmas. More importantly, we now join to open our hearts in preparation for this most blessed season. Today's service begins with the poetry offering, followed by the song Christmas Bells, sung by our preschool choir. After the song, preschool children may return to the family.
"Be not afraid,"
he said. She humbly bowed her head.
"The Christ child's mother you will be, for God has found favor with you."
"Oh, but this cannot be. I am not married, you see."
"Joseph will take you as his bride and stand as husband by your side."
"Then the Christ child's mother I will be, for it is God's will I seek for me." Then the man disappeared and Mary no longer feared. She quickly pondered in her heart how in God's plan she had such part, and she spoke with a magnificent smile, "I will humbly carry the Christ child."
Even in the midst of great joy and celebration, we know that our lives don't always reflect God's intentions. So please join me in the prayer confession printed in your bulletin, followed by a moment of silent reflection and personal confession.
For the ways in which we have been caught up in the frenzied spirits of the holidays and turned away from your spirit of peace, help us sing your peace. For the times we have focused so much on our own lives and desires that we have neglected your voice.
For those moments when our desire for making the season perfect has turned us away from the hurting people and broken places in our world in need of healing, help us
sing your mercy.
In the times we have dismissed Christmas as a time only for children and we have stubbornly closed our hearts to your amazing gift of love, help us
sing your joy.
Sometimes we miss what Christmas is all about. You coming to earth, Emmanuel, God with us. Help us hear your new promises of hope and salvation and love as we sing to you. Now hear our silent prayers and confession.
God's love knows no bounds. Love comes down at Christmas, a love so deep and so profound that nothing will ever be the same again.
Know the good news. The love has come for you, to touch you, to heal you, to forgive you, to make you whole. And that is the reason to sing. Amen.
I am a wise man with a myrrh that is so mild that
child.
We are three wise men with gifts rare and new. Will you with all honor bring gift for him too?
Our ushers will now collect in today's offerings.
Together today. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated.
Lord, your words are holy and true, just as the psalmist writes. We guard these scriptures in our heart. Thank you, God, for the divine inspiration you revealed to us in the Bible. Our Old Testament lesson in Psalm 96, sing God's brand new song. Earth and everyone in it sing. Sing to God, worship God. Shout the news of his victory from sea to sea. Take the news of his glory to the lost. News of his wonders to one and all. For God is great and worth a thousand hallelujahs. Bring gifts and celebrate. Bow before the beauty of God. Then to your knees, everyone worship. An extravaganza before God as he comes. As he comes to set everything right on earth. Set everything right. Treat everyone fair. And then the word of the Lord.
Tell those shepherds about the Messiah's birth.
born this day in a little time, and we need to sing God run them out.
And experience together in worship today. And You know, as I've done this before, I've often tried to watch something to happen in the midst of what's happening with the kids, and then sort of think about what that might mean for us as we think about Christmas. You know, I was watching all of this today, and I'm sure you were too, and I was watching it all the way from the beginning, from beforehand, as people were getting prepared, and as I walked down the stairs and looked at all the buzz going on up in the chancel, and everybody with pictures and setting up cameras, and people coming in to find their place, and people scouring over the bulletins, trying to decide what goes where, and trying to get everything right, and sets and the sound booth, setting up the microphones to make sure they're in the right place, and everything's working right, and someone said to me, just a little bit of chaos. A little bit of delightful, holy chaos. And that's life, isn't it? Life every day is a kind of wrestling between the edge of chaos and our attempts to make a little bit of order out of it, to make sense of it all. But I think if we spend too much time on the order side, we miss the creative side. For a little bit of chaos is necessary to discover a little bit of truth. The truth is that God works through the midst of it all. We've got everything going on in every moment of our lives. I dare say there is no moment that you have ever experienced in which only one thing is happening. Everything is happening all at once. We've got shepherds over in one corner. We've got angels over in another corner. We've got people reading words, people remembering stories. We've got people sort of jostling the place, trying to figure out who comes where, when, and why, and how. And then how do you start and how do you stop? And in the midst of it, we've got great things happening. We've got people kind of tripping over each other a little bit. We've got people discovering things they hadn't known before. We've got friendships being made. And we have a story being told. That is a story about what is most important of all. God comes to us in love. In a child. In a baby, in one place. He becomes the Lord of all for each one of us. And in the middle of everything that's happening, every once in a while, one of our angel wings, the ones that you're wearing when you came in this morning, every once in a while, it falls off. And then you gotta pick it back up. You gotta figure out how to put it back on so you can stay up with the crowd and so you can keep up with everything that's going on. And every once in a while, the most important thing is just to hold it in your hand. Because every one of us has those moments when the wing falls off, you gotta pick it up, you gotta put it back on, and you gotta remember that God sees us as the ones that God has made, a little lower than the angels, created in God's image, to remember and celebrate and tell God's story every day, especially at Christmas. Thank you, every single one of you, for making this possible today, and let us share in the time of fellowship. Let us first sing our praise. We sing. We have good courage, hold fast to what is good, render unto no one evil for evil, strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the afflicted, honor all people, love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. May the peace of God, that passes all understanding.